Stand by for words from the commanding officer.
Hello, CFAY. I'm Captain Dave Owen. It's Thursday, May 3rd, 2012. It's a little rainy out here today, but I'm up here at the military working dog kennels. You might see a couple of dogs in the background. We had a special event here earlier this morning, military working dog Lion, 11 years old, after over 10 years of faithful military service, retired. And it's another good story here. Good story here for Lion. He has been adopted by a former handler, so he's going to be going off to have a good retired life here. But I awarded him a Navy Commendation Medal earlier today, and good day for military working dog Lion. What hasn't been good days for us around here over the last few days is our drinking and driving. We've had four DWIs over the last 5 days. That is not good. That gives us 11 on the year. We need to do more than just count the numbers. We need to get those numbers down. We need to get proactive. And that's throughout the entire community. It's a problem for everybody. It's just not CFAY, it's just not me. Everyone needs to get on board to combat this. It sounds like an old record. I keep talking about drinking and driving. Well, that record's going to keep playing until it stops and we don't do it at all. There's lots of ways to try to avoid some of this stuff. I mean, I want to remind everybody, I mean, we have plenty of taxis on base. If you've had too much to drink, you can always get a taxi. The free taxi voucher program is not in effect right now, but it's going to start back up on the 25th of May and run through the 101 days of summer. So that is one program which you can start using again. You can use that program. Also, keep in mind, MWR still has the designated driver program. If you're a non-drinker, you can be designated as a designated driver. You can get free drinks that are non-alcoholic in nature, and you can be a designated driver. Need everybody to get on board here with this. We don't need any more DUIs, don't need any more DWIs, and we certainly don't want anybody getting hurt or killed due to a drunk driver. The last person that we picked up was at a sobriety checkpoint. The BAC was over 0.150, so more than twice the limit. And keep in mind, the penalties on base in the U.S. are not as stiff as they are out in town. Under Japanese law, that individual could be serving 5 years of jail time and paying up to a 1 million yen fine. So you need to, we need to knock this off. We need to get this under control. All right. Now on to some things that are a little bit more pleasant than that. I want to talk about next week. We have a Reliant Gale going on. Reliant Gale is our typhoon exercise. You'll be seeing me quite a bit on the videos next week going over that. We're going to step through all the different levels of T-Core, four all the way up through one. It's a good chance for you to go through your checklist, good chance for you to figure out what you need to have to be prepared if you don't already have it. In conjunction with that, it won't be happening next week. We're going to be scheduling it later in May. The Sullivan's evacuation drill that was supposed to happen last week got canceled due to bad weather. So the Sullivan School will still be doing their earthquake tsunami drill. We got to lock the date down, and we'll let you know what that date is. And when that happens, the kids and the teachers will be evacuating the school and going for higher ground as if something actually was happening. So this is all in our preparedness. We got to get ready. Even though it's just wet today, it'll get wet and a lot windier when the typhoons start coming later this year. This weekend for the high schoolers, remember the prom, the high school prom is this Saturday, so the high schoolers will be going down to the new Sano for the prom. And all you high schoolers that don't have dates yet for the prom, here's my advice, go stag, it's cool. You know, you get there, you don't have to leave with the one that brought you, you can dance with everybody else's dates. So don't sweat it right now if you don't have a date to the prom, you can still have a great time. Just go there on your own. That is a method has been tried and proven, by the way. I'm not going to say by who. All right, some closures I want to talk about. I brought these up a couple times before. The community bank at Nagishi is going to be closed from the 7th through the 22nd of May. That's in order to be doing some renovations at the branch there. The branch here at Yokosuka will be open. The ATMs will still be available up at Nagishi. 4th Street, behind the commissary and the NEX, there's a section of that road that had to be closed starting this week due to a steam line repair. We found this out at the end of last week. That's going to be closed all the way up to July, so you're going to have to it doesn't cut off any access to any of the housing areas back there, but it will require you to go around a different way that you might be used to in order to go to the commissary and the exchange. You may have to go all the way over to 3rd Street. And at the end of the month, on 27th May, Club Alliance is going to be closed on that day. I believe that's a Sunday, in order to do their annual maintenance there and cleaning on Club Alliance. Okay, also, as the weather starts warming up, I want to remind everybody to hydrate. We want to avoid heat stress conditions. Make sure you're taking in a lot of water as the temperatures start going up and the humidity starts getting higher. It's not too early to start preparing yourself for things like that. Remember to start getting in the habit of drinking lots of water. Okay, let's see, what have I got here next? There will be a demonstration down at the Kearney Gate on the 13th of May. You can expect that. That's on a Sunday. There'll be about 150 people down there. Don't expect any closures at the gate that day. But as with all demonstrations we have here, they're usually peaceful. In fact, they're always peaceful. They start when they're supposed to. They stop when they're supposed to. And we usually have no problems whatsoever. On the 12th of May, we've got Ikego Friendship Day coming up. Lots of events going on that day besides the friendship event itself. There's going to be a roller derby match at the Bubble Gym that morning, and there's going to be a 4K run. So you can come out and see the roller derby team playing and do a little running at the same time before the Friendship Day starts off. And later in that afternoon, you can come back here to the main installation at Berkey Field. The Seahawks will be playing that day. They play at 1600 on the 12th of May, and they'll be taking on Masala, one of the Air Force bases. We want to see if we can get a win over the Air Force teams this year. So on the 12th of May at 1600 over at Berkey Field, the Seahawks will be on the field. For those of you who live off base, the OHA survey is currently undergoing, and we need to get that completed. It's been extended out to the 11th of May. We need to get at least 50% participation so it can be counted and have the effects. So if you live off base and you receive OHA, please go online and fill out that survey. On the 19th of May, that's a Saturday, for dinner at the galley, we're going to have an open galley. This one was not planned originally, but what we're having coming in, we're going to have some celebrity chefs there on the 19th of May. So if you want to go to the galley on the evening of the 19th for your dinner, you can have some celebrity chefs over there, meet them and eat their cooking. And one last note I want to make everybody aware of, don't forget Mother's Day is coming up on the 13th. So make sure you take care of Mama. Get your presents, get your gifts, get your flowers ordered well in advance. Don't wait to the last minute. You don't want to forget Mom. She certainly won't forget you. All right, on to my trivia from the last video. The song I was looking for was Cold, Cold Heart, and that was answered by Rosemary Axe. And Rosemary had a really good day on the trivia because she had the next trivia question also. The movie was Healthy, Wealthy, and Dumb. And the characters I was looking for that starred in it were the Three Stooges. So Rosemary Axe got both of the trivia questions. Now for some new trivia questions. Here's a song. Here's the lyrics. You give me the title and an artist that did it. I've been known to cause a few births. I've been known to cause a few breakups. I can make you new friends and get you fired from work. All right. Come up with the name of that title song. I actually got a couple of those lyrics backwards, but those are the lyrics in the song, and see what you can come up with on that one. And for a movie, who was hailed, this is one of my grandmother's all-time favorite movies, at his birth, who was hailed in this movie as the Prince of the Forest? The Prince of the Forest. Who was the Prince of the Forest? Okay, that one's pretty cool. Now for my sports trivia question, this one actually just happened a couple days ago. I was at the Bay Stars game in Yokohama, and one of the players, unfortunately it wasn't for the Bay Stars, he played for the other team, hit three home runs that game. Who was the player who hit three home runs against the Bay Stars Tuesday night up in Yokohama? See if you can come up with that one and get me his name. And while I'm speaking about the Bay Stars, remember, if you want some alternatives to going out in the haunch and drinking and taking that ignorant oil, there's the Bay Stars not only up in Yokohama, there's the Bay Stars here in Yokosuka, the minor league team. Minor league team plays over in Opama at Yokosuka Stadium. Only 1,000 yen for a ticket. It's a good time. I mean, there's a couple things you should do during your tour here in Japan. One of them is, they say, you should climb Mount Fuji, because if you don't climb Mount Fuji, you're going to wind up having to climb it again. You're going to wind up coming back to Japan, is the old saying. And you should definitely take in a Japanese baseball game. It's definitely different than what you see in the States, especially at the major league level up at Yokohama. And you might run across some players that you'll see later in life. The team that was playing Tuesday night, one of their players was Lasting Millage. He's an American. I remember when he was playing for Norfolk on the Tides, and he played for the Mets for a little bit. Now he's over here. And you might have heard of this guy named Yu Darvish, who pitched here in Japan last year. He now plays in the States, and he's already got a record of 4-0 with the Texas Rangers. So if you're a baseball fan, you definitely don't want to miss out going to some of the Japanese baseball games here. All right, as usual, CFAY, I would just remind everybody, good shipmates don't let shipmates drink and drive. Good shipmates don't let shipmates do drugs. And good shipmates don't let shipmates get sexually assaulted. Have a great weekend, CFAY, and I'll talk to you next week.
Oh no, I'm late for work. Oh, my head. Oh, where are my keys?
Good morning, sir. This is the command authorized sobriety checkpoint. I'm gonna need you to exhale into the cup. Sir, I'm gonna need you to step out of the vehicle with me. Sir, you're being placed under military apprehension under the suspicion of driving while intoxicated.